Son and the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. I'm very delighted to be here today in the Church of the Holy Cross, Catholic Orthodox Church. It's wonderful. Even in your idea, you choose a beautiful name for the church. Most of the people force, and which is great, go after some of the name of the church saints, but this is a unique idea, and we have to emphasize this in our church. The Church of the Holy Cross is great. May the blessing and the power of the cross be with us and help us to continue in this great project. Your idea is going to spread all over the state, and we like it. It is wonderful to take care of the new generation and the generation of their generations. While you are in the fast of Saint Mary, let me speak with you generally, by the grace of God, about Saint Mary. Not to encourage you to fast, because there is no need to make some publicity or encouragement for the fast of Saint Mary. Because our people love to fast in general and love Saint Mary in particular. And it's very rare if you find some people from our church never fast or do not fast the fast of Saint Mary. Even some other non-believers, some Muslims in Egypt, sometimes they fast the fast of Saint Mary. And of course, when we say the fast of Saint Mary, we never ever offer any worship idea like prayer or fasting to any of the saints, including Saint Mary. But of course, all our worship to God, and through it, we take the blessing of Saint Mary, or we have the fast of the apostle, and so on. Saint Mary, we venerate her much in our church. And let me, in summary, and in few points, address Saint Mary Theotokos, the Mother of God, in a very orthodox way. The best way we can approach her, and many of our subject in our church, we have to talk to her not only from the historical point of view, but this will be the first part, Saint Mary from the historical point of view. The second part will be Saint Mary from the dogmatic point of view, what we believe in her. And then Saint Mary from the ritual point of view, and I will conclude briefly Saint Mary from the spiritual point of view. Many of our subjects in our church, if we address it this way, historically or biblically, and then from the ritual, from the dogmatic, from the spiritual, we can explain the subject from all the aspects. In brief, Saint Mary, from the historical point of view, her parents, Joachim and Anna, they were childless, without children. They prayed to the Lord, asked the Lord to give them a child. And then, when they did not receive their request right away, they continued in their seeking and asking until the Lord gave them Saint Mary. Before that, they devoted her to the temple. Said, Lord, if you give us a child, and they assume at the time maybe they will have a boy, we'll give him to the altar to be like altar boy, to serve in the altar, and then the Lord gave them a girl. Not knowing his divine plan, and they fulfilled their vow, after 3 years they put her to serve in the altar. She stayed in the altar for about nine years, from age 3 to age 12, where she served in a very difficult atmosphere. The altar and the sanctuary and the near and the holy and the holy of the holy in the Old Testament is different than here, where in the altar they can see the slaughters of the animals and so on, and at the end here she has to clean and she has to. In the book of Synaxarion, even while she was young, 5, 6, 7 years old, she had a certain amount they offer her to eat, breakfast, lunch, and the dinner. Most of the time she gives her food to the poor, even while she was very young. No wonder why the Lord chose her to be his own mother. And in the book of St. Exilian, it mentioned that the angel appeared to her with some heavenly food to satisfy her need. This is St. Mary Eden while she was praying. At the age of 12 or 13, while she had to leave the altar, the priest and the high priest gave her to St. Joseph. He was older than her 7 times. Like St. Joseph at that time, and his age is 78 to 8 years old. To be in the trust of him, but not to be as husband and wife. And then, while she was in St. Joseph's house, she received the annunciation that she is going to be the mother of God. She asked the question for Archangel Gabriel, not to push it out or she don't want to accept it, but just for the clarification. And when he said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and you will be pregnant, and you have a child, and his name will call his Jesus, for Jesus he will save. Jesus means the Savior. And later on also we know that his name will be Emmanuel, God is us. When she knew the reason, because in her heart she devoted herself to be celibate, and she is not planned to get married. How can this happen to me since I don't know man? Then when he told her the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and then she knew the reason, she submitted herself to the Lord, and she said to the Archangel Gabriel, I am the servant of the Lord, let it be to me according to thy word. And the early church father said, this particular time she had been conceived, and this is, if you calculate the time, from the day of the Annunciation to the day of Nativity, exactly 9 months. This is why we have the Annunciation in April 7 and Christmas in January 7. It's exactly 9 months since she accepted. God never forced her, but offered her the idea. She accepted. She became pregnant of our Lord Jesus Christ, and later on she gave him birth on the Christmas day. The matter continued historically for St. Mary. You know the story when she went in Egypt with St. Joseph, and our Lord Jesus Christ, they came back, they lived in Nazareth, and our Lord Jesus Christ started his ministry when he was 30 years old. After 3 years of his ministry, he was crucified on the cross for our salvation. At that particular time on the cross, the Lord had St. Mary, St. John, the beloved. Mother, this is your son. Son, this is your mother. And then, and I always say, if you stay to Jesus in the cross, in your church, in the Holy Cross, you are going to be elevated to be one of the Holy Family. Saint John, the beloved God, elevated him to be part of the Holy Family because he stayed all the way to the cross. She stayed with Saint John for 14 years, and then she departed in peace. This is the historical aspect of St. Mary. And you see the icon here, the adoration of St. Mary. When our Lord Jesus Christ, this icon, the Greek Orthodox or the Romanian, the Lord Jesus Christ appeared on her day of departure and took her soul. He carried like a lady, like St. Mary, in his hand. He said, this is in the theology of iconographer, this is the spirit of St. Mary. And he did not wish to leave her body here on earth, but he took her body, and no corruption happened to her body. But this is different than the ascension. Our Lord Jesus Christ was died and resurrected, and then he ascended. But this is she died according to the flesh, and then her spirit with the Lord, but also who kept her body. This is quickly about St. Mary from the historical point of view. St. Mary, from the dogmatic or theological point of view, if I may say, much better use the word dogmatic point of view, what do you believe about St. Mary? There is 3 very important things about St. Mary. St. Mary is the mother of God, Theotokos. St. Mary, ever virgin, she was virgin and continued to be virgin even after she gave birth to our Lord Jesus Christ. And St. Mary, the great intercessor in front of the Lord. This is very important, and this is identifying us as Orthodox. Who sent Mary for us? Saint Mary is the Otokos, the mother of God. It was a great debate and fight in the early church, especially in the Third Ecumenical Council. And as I said yesterday in the church of St. Mark, that even one of the patriarchs, Nestor, was the patriarch of Constantinople. He did not accept the idea of Otokos, Saint Mary, the mother of God. And she said, you know, he said, she's the mother of Jesus, but not the mother of God. We know that even when you say mother of God, she is not the mother of the Trinity, God forbid, but she is the mother of the incarnate God. Who is our Lord Jesus Christ? Our Lord Jesus Christ is the incarnate God. When we say incarnate, then God appeared in the flesh and God is God. He's full in his divinity and full in his humanity. And he became one nature out of two natures, what we call, and this is the expression of Saint Cyril the Great and Saint Athanasius the Great, the one nature of the incarnate God. طبيعة الواحدة للكلمة المتلس. And it's very clear that Saint Mary is the mother of God. You remember what we say now, the Archangel Gabriel said, you conceive and you bear a son, and his name is Jesus. His name is Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God is with us. You remember when Saint Mary visited Saint Elizabeth after she heard the Annunciation. Saint Elizabeth lived by the Holy Spirit. And then she looked at her and said, when Saint Mary greeted her, she said, how this granted to me that the mother of my God will come and visit me? While I heard your greeting, my baby lived in my womb. So I know for a fact that the Archangel Gabriel said to Saint Mary about Saint Elizabeth's pregnancy. This is fact. Remember when he said to her, your cousin Elizabeth, she now is pregnant on the 6 months of her pregnancy. So this is information of how Saint Elizabeth knew that Saint Mary pregnant with Jesus Christ and he is the Lord. This is by the Spirit, led by the Spirit. And it very act, even Saint John, by the Spirit, worship our Lord Jesus Christ as God incarnate, even while both of them in their mother wombs. This is amazing. So this is just two proofs and many others about Saint Mary is the Otoko, the mother of God. And in the Church of Ephesus, in the year 461, the church led by Saint Cyril the Great, and in all the universal churches come together and they put the introduction of the creed. We magnify you, O Mother of God, Azimika Ulumur, we magnify you, O Mother of God. Insist about the faith in Sukutu, Mother of God. Saint Mary is ever virgin. She was virgin before and she continued to be virgin after. And some of the Protestant churches, or most of them, try to fight with us or with the Lord about his virginity, and I don't know why they insisted to do so. Biblically, she was virgin before and after. In the book of Ezekiel, he said, a door opened in the east, the Lord entered and came out and still the door shut. It's very clear. And as I said, when Saint Mary asked the Archangel, how can this happen to me since I don't know man? In her mind, she would like to continue to be virgin. Saint Joseph was only like a garden for the Holy Family, for our Lord Jesus Christ and Saint Mary. When Saint Joseph doubted her purity, when he found that she became pregnant, and he knew that he did not touch her, the Bible said he would like to let her go secretly. And then the Lord sent an angel in a dream to Saint Joseph and told him, Joseph, son of God, a son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because the one was pregnant by the Holy Spirit. Notice that he said, Mary as your wife. After she gave birth to our Lord Jesus Christ, he did not relate Saint Mary to Joseph. He said, wake up, arise, take the child and his mother and go to Egypt. This is very important. In the same Gospel of St. Luke, take the child and his mother and go to Egypt. At the beginning, St. Augustine said, it's okay that the people have impression that Joseph is the father of Jesus and St. Mary is his mother. Although this is wrong, but it's good for the people, St. Augustine said that, it's good the people have that impression for a while, then they will say about St. Mary, she commit adultery from marriage, so for a while. But after she gave birth to our Lord Jesus Christ, he related our Lord Jesus Christ to St. Mary and not to Joseph. And so on, many other proofs about her virginity. And also St. Augustine said, the Lord, as well as he was one, who called one begotten son of the Father, he also was one for his mother, St. Mary. Why the Protestant St. Augustine try to explain Matthew 12, when they said to him, your mother and your brother waiting for you outside. If you know the custom and the tradition, the culture in the Middle East, they address the cousin, first cousin from both sides as brother. So St. Mary was outside, yes, this is his own mother, but with her, his cousins. St. Mary had another sister, and her name